Good afternoon, Miss Jisa.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, Miss Jisa, can you tell me about yourself?
Okay, ma'am. Jisa Sabino Labaco. I'm 31 years old. I am married but I have no children. I live in Libang, Makati, Aklan. My recent work experience is sales assistant in different establishments and also a domestic helper in Doha, Qatar in almost 2 years. That's all, ma'am.
Okay, I have a few questions for you to answer, so let's start. Why do you want to work as a maid?
I want to work as a maid because I want to help my family.
Why you choose Malaysia when there is a lot of other countries?
I choose Malaysia, ma'am, because it's near in the Philippines.
How are you qualified for this job?
I qualify for this job because I have an experience.
May I know what is your education level is?
My education level is college level, ma'am.
What is your recent experience?
My recent experience is domestic helper in Doha, Qatar in almost 2 years.
Have you worked abroad before?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you please tell the place and how many years you work for?
I work in Doha, Qatar in almost 2 years.
Do you have experience of taking care of baby?
Yes, ma'am.
And whose baby you are taking care of?
Abdullah Muhammad.
Mm-hmm. So this is your employer's baby?
Yes, ma'am.
So how old is the baby when you take care?
2 years old.
Okay, what about elder? Do you have experience taking care of an elder?
Yes, ma'am.
So whose elder you are taking care of?
Jeannie Chua.
Miss Jeannie Chua. Okay. So how are you related to Miss Jeannie Chua?
I'm not related to him, ma'am, but my friend is related to him.
Okay, so this is the relative of your friend.
Yes, ma'am.
So how old do you take care of her?
60 years old, ma'am.
Mm-hmm, 60 years old. Do you have any other special skills?
Yes, ma'am.
So can you tell me your special skills?
Cooking, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Are you willing to learn new skills?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you willing to work with a family where the mother-in-law or any relative stay together?
Yes, ma'am.
Currently, are you still working now?
No, ma'am.
Do you know how to cook?
Yes, ma'am.
What sort of food can you cook?
Filipino food and also Arabic food.
Okay, so in Filipino food, what dishes that, what Filipino dishes that you can cook?
Adobo, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Adobo. Okay, what about Arabic food? What dishes that you can cook?
Rice bukhari.
Okay. Are you aware that you will have to do washing, cleaning, ironing, and cooking?
Yes, ma'am.
From all the house chores or household work, such as washing, cleaning, ironing, and cooking, which do you like most?
All of the above, ma'am.
Okay. You are not allowed to use handphone during working hours.
It's okay, ma'am.
You are only allowed to use handphone after you finish all the works and when going to bed.
Yes, ma'am.
You are strictly needed to surrender the handphone to your employer in the morning and your employer will return back to you once you're going to bed.
Yes, ma'am.
If ever your employer finds out that you're abusing your handphone and it's affected your work performance, your employer will confiscate your handphone and you're not allowed to hold it anymore. Instead, your employer will allow you to call to your family 3 times in a month. You're only allowed to bring normal phone and you're not allowed to bring smartphone. Are you agreed for the terms and condition?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you agreed to the rules and regulation for the handphone?
Yes, ma'am.
How many years is the contract as you agreed and understand?
2 years, ma'am.
Can you describe for me your ethics or your attitude?
Hardworking and disciplined.
How can you assure to us that you will work hard in Malaysia?
I assure, ma'am, because I have a lot of experience for this job.
Okay. Can you promise not to use the telephone without the permission of your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to put on makeup but to dress properly while work?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to invite friends and relatives without the consent of your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you promise not to ask for advance salary from your employer under any circumstances?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you really understand of the rules and regulation of the agency?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you pay any placement fee for you to come to Malaysia to work as a maid?
No, ma'am.
Do you have any history of sickness, example breast cancer or any other illness?
No, ma'am.
Do you suffer from any skin diseases, allergy or physical defect?
No, ma'am.
Have you suffered from any serious illness?
No, ma'am.
Have you undergone any operation?
No, ma'am.
Are you medically fit?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you in any medication?
No, ma'am.
Are you allergic with any food?
No, ma'am.
Are you prepared to work for the employer of any race?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you prepared to eat the type of food taken by your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you afraid of being left alone in the house?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Are you afraid of dogs or other pets?
No, ma'am.
Can you promise to work according to instruction from your employer?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any immediate family working in Malaysia?
No, ma'am.
Okay, Ms. Jisa, we have finished our question section. Let's go to case study. I have a case study for you and I want you to answer me truthfully. Upon arrival in Malaysia, within 6 months, if ever any of your family members pass away, what will you do? Will you continue to work till finish your contract or you will go back?
I continue my contract, ma'am. I finished 2 years there.
Tell us about yourself and why do you want to work in Malaysia as domestic helper?
I want to work in Malaysia and as domestic helper because I want to help my family for their financial needs.
Okay, Ms. Jisa, what do you want to tell to your employer who watching your video?
Hi, sir, madam. I'm Jisa Sabina Labaco. I'm 31 years old. I promise to do my ability for this job.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Jessa. We will update your agency if there's any selection made by the employer.
Thank you, ma'am.